I'm Emily Richett, and you're watching Amplify. In this episode, I'm taking you inside ClickFunnels' annual conference, Funnel Hacking Live, where we'll meet entrepreneurs who are on top of their game so we can reverse engineer their tactics, model their mindset, and hack their success. Hi, I'm Emily Richett here at ClickFunnels' annual event, Funnel Hacking Live, and fresh off the stage, the ultimate funnel hacker, Dean Holland.
Hey.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, now, I say amazing. The ultimate funnel hacker because Russell Brunson has deemed you someone who's built the ultimate funnel, and that's right. What you're just talking about on stage. But let's backtrack a little bit and go to that point in your life when you were really successful as an internet marketer, making hundreds of thousands a month. Yet something wasn't quite right. Take us to that place.
Yeah, so when I first started my business, I was very much chasing that financial success, and I thought that was kind of all it was about, and I achieved it, thankfully, but I ended up in a position where I sort of started to lose my passion. I didn't understand why, and so I couldn't actually bring myself every day. I was like lying on the sofa, or I was just laying there with my dog, but an English bulldog, and we just lay on the sofa every day, and I wasn't getting anything done, and I really felt unmotivated, uninspired, and it was the first time that had happened to me in my business. And I was in a position where I was really lost with it. I didn't understand what was going on or why that was. And through the help that actually Russell gave me, I realized that I'd gone about building my business in a way where I'd ended up attracting a lot of the wrong customers, like people that I couldn't truly serve in the way that I wanted to and the way that I could. And so we were bringing in thousands of customers a month, but they're all the wrong type of customers, you know. And so end up in this position where everything we kept continued to service and offer those customers, because I do coaching and consulting, things like this, there were a lot of people that I really wasn't suitably matched to, if that makes any sense. And so, yes, we had all the financial success, and everyone on the outset would probably think, wow, life's amazing, you've got it all. But on the inside, I was actually terrified and really scared about the whole mess I was in.
Wow. So most people can understand, even if they don't use a funnel or if they don't use ClickFunnels, they understand the concept of you're getting customers in at an initial engagement or price point, let's say, and then they're going up the value ladder of your business. So initially I wouldn't think, I'll just take anyone that wants to buy my initial offer, cool, but you're saying down the road, now you're having to work closely with these people that you didn't really love.
Exactly.
What can we do in our businesses to get that right from the beginning?
Yeah, no, great question. So the way in which I got it wrong, just like you've just said, is I started offering that initial product, that kind of entry-level product to bring a customer into the business, and I started from there. So I just started offering this product without any sort of thought into, well, actually, where am I taking these people and who do I actually want? And so the way in which I ended up solving that was to start thinking about the end goal first. So who do I want to serve and why? You know, what value can I bring? You know, so the coaching and the consulting that we do, you started to plan that through first. You know, who can I truly help? Who can what we do truly serve and make an impact with? And then starting to come back to that initial offering and say, well, what is the ideal initial offer for that person? Because when I did things the other way, like you say, anyone and everyone was buying that first thing within our marketplace, and a percentage of them was buying that next thing, but it just wasn't the right match of people. And so now we always think about the end goal first and then plan what is the perfect thing to bring those people in.
I love it, because you said you had a plan how to get rich and be miserable.
Yes.
And that is the plan when you do it wrong, but now thinking end goal in mind, then you can get rich and be happy.
Exactly, and you can truly help people, which is what it's about.
Well, and you also did something really interesting. For people that build funnels in their business, we think of them as kind of separate entities. You have different types of funnels.
Right.
And you've kind of merged some of the funnels together. A big thing you talk about is one of the most overlooked pages, or if you don't necessarily use a funnel, let's think of it as a step in your online business process.
Right.
It completely overlooked, but it can be one of the most powerful pages.
Right.
What is that? And talk us through that.
Yeah, so whenever you get a new customer or a new subscriber into your business, you generally see that as time goes on, the less responsive those people become because they've got other distractions and a lot of things going on. And so what we started to notice and look at was when they first became a customer, that's when we had them at the peak of their interest and engagement with us as a business. And so we started to look more at, well, how can we serve them faster and immediately where we've got most of their attention? And so for us, we realized that one of the pages or parts of the business we was underutilizing was what we call the thank you page. which is essentially the part of our website that we send people to after they've ordered our initial offerings. So they would order that first thing or a couple of things, and then that is kind of like the page where most people just say, thank you very much for ordering.
Thank you, go check your inbox. That's what
exactly,
mine says right now.
Exactly, yeah. Right. So you say thank you very much and you tell them what they can expect next.
Right.
Well, what we started doing was taking that message, but then immediately start actually informing them about other things that we do. You know, so for me, the coaching side of things, we would immediately make them aware that we do have another opportunity where they can work closer with me and my company. Wow. You know, offering that next thing immediately, because pretty much 100% of people are going to see that page.
Yeah, as opposed to just sending them an email sequence and hoping
exactly.
they buy. So you start your webinar right on that thank you page, or you
exactly.
make that next offer. That is brilliant. Dean Holland, thank you so much for sharing this. Go with the end goal in mind,
yeah.
right? And make sure to utilize some of those underserved pages in your funnel.
Yeah, exactly.
And then you can get rich and be happy.
Exactly.
All
That's
right,
the goal.
Thanks
thank
so
you
much.
So much.